is a story we have all heard before. A simple Friday tweak intended to improve a critical system turned into Monday mayhem. That's change management gone wrong. However, before we learn how to implement changes seamlessly, we will quickly define what we mean by a change. In ITSM, a change in an organization refers to the addition, removal, or modification of any IT services for better operational efficiency. There are three types of changes in ITSM. Standard changes, which are routine, risk-free, and could be automatically approved. Something like replacing router. Emergency changes, which needs to be implemented as fast as possible, usually in response to security issues. It could be the deployment of a security patch for zero-day vulnerability. Finally, normal changes include any other change that does not fit into one of the previous two classifications. A subset for normal changes are major changes, which involve a large project such as moving on-premise apps to the cloud. Now, organizations require unique processes for each type of change to strategically plan, govern, and implement changes with minimal disruptions to the production environment. Let's see how ManageEngine ServiceDesk Plus enables risk-free change management with robust approvals and automated workflows. This is Michael, an IT admin who has been tasked with moving application from the on-premises environment to the cloud. His team uses ServiceDesk Plus to manage this change. To start the change, he creates a change request by choosing a relevant template from the drop-down menu. As you can see, a workflow associated with the template was updated automatically. Michael then fills in the details of the change by designating the right stakeholders for each change role and justifying why the change is required. He also outlines the risks associated with the change and submits the request for change. You can configure similar templates to pre-fill forms for frequently requested changes and map appropriate workflows. You can also customize different aspects of change, such as change type, cab teams, change stage and status, and change roles. To guide and drive the change automatically, you can lay a solid graphical roadmap using change workflows. Customize stages specific to a change type on the drag and drop canvas. Make use of the condition and branch notes to direct the change and add actions like approvals, notifications, and field updates specific to each stage and complete the workflow. Michael opens the request and the change is in the planning stage. He adds the details on how the change would impact the organization and its users. He also outlines the rollout plans, the backout plans, and expected downtime. This planning is a crucial step for the change as it fosters informed decision-making, risk mitigation, and effective communication. Once the planning is complete, the change then moves to the CAB approval stage. The CAB or the change advisory board reviews the change plan and adds their recommendations. You can customize a CAB by adding different group members to approve a particular change. You can also direct the change to pass through multiple group approvals using the fork branch node that splits the change workflow along different paths. Once the CAB members and the change manager greenlight the change, it becomes ready for implementation. Now, to track the implementation, Michael starts adding and assigning tasks to different technicians and mapping their dependencies. Once all the tasks are completed and the change has been implemented, the change moves to the release stage. Michael associates a release request to this change ticket. Let's put a pause on this change process and understand what a release is and why it is important. Release management is an ITSM practice that controls the building, testing, and deployment of software releases safely. A structured release management process is important to deploy the change implementation into the live IT environment with minimal blips and disruptions. In Service Desk Plus, similar to change management, release management can include customized release templates, designated release roles, established workflows, and approvals. Now, once the associated release is deployed, the change moves into the review stage, where predefined change reviewers can check for any deviations from the initial change plan. Finally, Michael closes the change by assigning a closure code based on the nature of the change closure. The stakeholders are automatically notified of this successful change closure. That's how Service Desk Plus aids in transforming your organization with seamless change management. To learn more about Service Desk Plus, visit servicedeskplus.com and follow our YouTube channel.